Photocopy Love by Alex Brown. The serving desk of a photocopying store. Daytime. Bonita and Tyrone are working behind the desk. Raph enters.
Good afternoon. Can I help you?
I'd like to have some binding done.
We'll have to book it in. We're pretty busy.
You don't look busy.
I assure you, sir, we are very busy.
Positive you can't squeeze me in. Pretty please with sugar on top.
Tyrone, can you go and get some more toner cartridge from the storeroom?
I think we're okay.
We've got a big order coming in later, and the toner on number 3 is running low.
Warning light's not flashing.
Just do it.
Tyrone exits. Bonita waits for him to go.
What are you doing here?
I was desperate to see you. I had to come.
Oh, you know the boss, what the boss said. No personal visits. You almost got me fired
last time. I know, but I couldn't help myself.
It's not what you said Thursday night. You said you had to work.
It was beyond my control.
Now I'm working.
You don't understand. What I feel is an emergency.
Raph reaches over to grab Bonita.
Stop it.
My arms have a life of their own. And as for my lips... tease.
You're the tease. Got me all hot and heavy on Thursday, and then you're a no-show?
How about tonight?
I may have other plans.
What's his name?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Who's the tease now?
You deserve some of your own medicine.
Raph starts to climb up over the desk.
What are you doing?
If you don't say you'll go out with me tonight, right this second, I'll come over there and ravage you.
Stop it. People are looking.
Then I'll kneel down here and profess my undying love to you, to the whole world.
Raph kneels.
Get up.
Bonita Russell is the most beautiful, most sexy, most intelligent, most caring person in the entire world, and I can't live without her one more second.
She goes around the side of the desk and pulls him up.
Look, this is really sweet, but I need my job.
I'm going to look after you.
A kept woman?
Forever and ever.
Make it sound so very tempting.
Come with me.
Now?
Right this second.
And do what?
Come back to my house for an afternoon of wild, passionate love.
Oh, you are hard to resist.
You know, you're right.
Tyrone enters. Bonita immediately jumps back from Raph.
Mr. Dev wants to see you.
Mr. Dev? Why?
Didn't say.
Where is he?
In his office.
Bonita turns to Raph.
Well, sir, that order may be ready sooner than you think.
Bonita exits. Tyrone goes straight to the front of the desk.
What are you doing here?
I was desperate to see you. I had to come.
If Bonita finds out, she'll kill us. Well, she'll kill you and fire me.
I know, but I couldn't help myself.
That's exactly what you said the other night.
It was beyond my control.
Mine too.
You don't understand. What I feel is an emergency.
He reaches over to grab Tyrone.
Not here.
My arms have a life of their own. And as for my lips...
They've got some rule about personal visits.
Tease.
I'll be whatever you want me to be.
How about tonight?
I'm meeting up with a friend. Maybe they could join us?
What's his name?
Who cares about their name?
Who's the tease now?
Not for long.
Raph starts to come around the other side of the desk.
What are you doing?
If you don't say you'll go out with me tonight, right this second, I'll come over there and ravage you.
Oops, you're already here.
Then I'll kneel down here and profess my undying love to you, to the whole world.
Raph kneels.
You just have to profess it to me.
Tyrone Alderton is the most beautiful, most sexy, most intelligent, most caring person in the entire world, and I can't live without him one more second.
Tyrone kneels as well.
Then stop telling me. Show me.
I'm going to look after you.
Then stop talking.
Forever and ever.
Now we'll do fine.
Come with me.
I'm trying.
Right in a second.
That's about how long it'll take.
Come back to my house for an afternoon of wild, passionate love.
What's wrong with right here?
You know, you're right.
Bonita enters. Raph immediately jumps back from Tyrone.
Sorry, sir. Customers aren't allowed on this side of the desk.
Rath goes back to the other side of the desk.
How did it go with Mr. Dev?
Fine. He just wanted some help with some stock orders.
So any chance of getting that order now?
I'm sorry, sir. We've seemed to have become a little busy.
As I tried to explain, it's an emergency.
Well, perhaps Tyrone can help you?
I'd be happy to.
Rath turns to Bonita.
If you're sure.
Tyrone is probably the more appropriate staff member for your needs.
If you say so.
Tyrone comes forward.
But then again, I may be able to fit it in. How big is the task?
It's quite ample.
Will it take long?
Depends on your equipment.
Oh, well, I'm afraid I can't make any guarantees.
Then perhaps I should utilize Tyrone's services.
I'll tell you what.
Why don't you leave us your name and number? We'll check out our workload, and once we see who's better placed to service you, we'll give you a call.
Bonita hands Rath a form.
Right here, please.
You'll call.
I'll call. Or it might be Tyrone.
You can't tell me now.
As I said, we are very busy.
I would prefer to know now.
Do you want the best person for the job, or do you just want anybody to do it?
The important thing is getting it done.
Fine. Then leave it with us.
Okay. You'll call?
Yes. We'll call.
Is that a promise?
Absolutely.
And we always keep our promises.
Right. Then I look forward to hearing from you.
Goodbye.
She looks at the form.
Mr. McCoy.
Good afternoon.
He looks at her name tag.
Bonita.
Bonita turns. Rath looks to Tyrone. Tyrone gestures for him to go and that he'll call him later. Bonita turns back.
Anything else we can help you with?
No, I'm fine.
Rath exits.
What was all that about?
I have no idea. So, what time tonight?
Any time you like.
Tyrone goes to Bonita and pulls her close.
Someone will see.
Don't worry. Mr. Dev is still out back in the storeroom.
So, when are we gonna tell Rav?
Let the bastard suffer.
They kiss. Lights fade. End of play.